Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is NIPS and NIDS. So let's get started. Introduction to NIPS and NIDS. Network Intrusion Prevention System, NIPS, and Network Intrusion Detection System, NIDS, are critical components in cybersecurity. They're like the guardians of a computer network. NIDS keeps an eye out for suspicious activities or possible threats, while NIPS goes a step further to actively stop or mitigate these threats. Below, we break down the essentials of NIPS and NIDS, how they work, the problems they face, and the tools and techniques they use. NIPS and NIDS, what's the difference? Intrusion Detection System, IDS. Think of IDS like a security camera in a store. It watches people, or, in this case, network traffic, and alerts the store owner, the system administrator, if it sees someone doing something suspicious, like a potential hacker or malware. However, it won't directly stop the theft, it simply alerts you. Intrusion Prevention System, IPS. IPS, on the other hand, is like a security guard in the store. It not only detects suspicious behavior but also takes action to prevent theft, unauthorized access or data breaches. So, in a way, IPS is more proactive than IDS. Combined Systems. Sometimes, you can have a system that combines both IDS and IPS features. This gives you the benefits of both surveillance and active protection. Categories of IDS, IPS. Network-based, NIDS, NIPS. These systems monitor the entire network for suspicious activities. They're like a CCTV system installed at all entrances and exits to a building, watching for any unauthorized entry. Host-based, HIDS, HIPS. These are installed on individual computers or hosts in a network. They're like having a security camera inside each apartment in a building. The problem of false positives. Imagine your security system mistaking a friendly neighbor for a thief. False positives are when the IDS, IPS wrongly flags benign activities as malicious. This can be frustrating and consume valuable time and resources. How NIDS and NIPS work. Monitoring traffic for breaches. Both NIDS and NIPS keep an eye on the data packets being sent and received across a network. If they notice something out of the ordinary, they take appropriate action depending on whether it's an IDS or IPS system. Active response options. NIDS can alert administrators about the issue, while NIPS can take direct action like blocking the user, terminating the session, or isolating the affected network segment. Diversion tactics, honeypots and padded cells. These are traps set to lure in potential hackers. A honeypot is like a fake treasure chest filled with fake jewels to divert a thief. A padded cell is an isolated environment where suspected malware or attackers can be safely studied without causing harm to the real network. Special features of host-based systems, HIDS. Unlike NIDS or NIPS, a host-based intrusion detection prevention system is specialized for individual computers. HIDS can monitor not only network traffic but also system files and configurations for any unauthorized changes. Active versus passive systems. Active IDS, IPS. An active system is like a security guard who immediately reacts to neutralize a threat. For instance, if it detects a malware attack, it will block the malware from entering the system. Passive IDS, IPS. A passive system enhances data logs and alerts the administrators. It's more like a security camera that captures footage for later review but doesn't intervene directly. Tools for monitoring networks. Monitoring tools like performance monitors, IDSs, and protocol analyzers can be used together to keep an eye on your network. Performance monitors check the health of your system, IDSs look for security threats, and protocol analyzers dissect the data packets to understand the kind of traffic flowing through your network. Types of detection methods. Signature-based. This is like recognizing a criminal from a wanted poster. Signature-based systems have a database of known attack patterns, and they match incoming traffic against this database. Heuristic, behavioral. Here, the system learns what normal behavior looks like and then flags anything that seems out of the ordinary. Anomaly-based. Anomaly-based systems maintain a baseline of normal network behavior and alert administrators if they notice a deviation. Positioning and timing, inline and in-band. Inline IPS. An inline system directly interacts with incoming traffic, blocking or allowing it in real time. In-band and out-of-band IDS. In-band systems monitor activities both before and after a connection is established, while out-of-band systems only oversee activities before the connection. Evaluating IDS/IPS performance. Importance of rules. Rules in IDS help distinguish between benign and malicious traffic, similar to how traffic rules distinguish between safe and unsafe driving behavior. Analytics. Just like your review security footage to gauge the effectiveness of your physical security measures, IDS analytics help evaluate the system's performance by assessing true and false positives and negatives. The critical concern of false negatives. While false positives can waste resources, false negatives are far more dangerous. This is when malicious activity goes undetected, allowing harm to occur without any warning. Conclusion. Understanding NIPS and NIDS is crucial for maintaining robust network security. By monitoring traffic and taking appropriate action, these systems form the first line of defense against a variety of cyber threats. However, it's essential to understand their limitations and continually update them to adapt to new types of cyber attacks. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website and don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. If you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.